some heroes of mine, the band Driving and Crying. This is a song from a couple of records back. This is called Cold Night in Santa Fe. Here we go. Acting like nothing's wrong. I'm all right, thank you for asking. Just rocking out, sounds good. Sort of healthy as two dogs. I apartments right there. And so I changed every one of the lyrics to be about a super fucked up relationship where the whole thing is falling apart and it's never gonna last. And I wrote that fucking song. And I listened back the next day and I said, damn, that's pretty good. So I recorded it and I put it on the record. And my wife liked it too, but I still haven't written a happy song about our relationship. So I'd like to play you this one now. Thank you. First told me I don't watch a lot of NASCAR, but I do know that friends that do will tell you that duct tape will fix damn near anything. If I learned anything in my course of rock and roll years, I have held together all sorts of parts of a trailer, parts of a van, parts of an amplifier, parts of a guitar, parts of a drum set, with 200 mile an hour NASCAR duct tape. So I feel certain that our dear friend that just ran up here duct tape whatever the fuck he duct taped. He's gonna be just fine. And as soon as he gets back down there, he's gonna turn this microphone back on. And then I don't have to holler at y'all. I can just move right over here and y'all still hear me. Successful illusions.
Yeah.
out about this next song. There's a famous club in Nashville, Tennessee called the Exit Inn. When I was underage, I used to sneak down there quite a few times to try and see bands that I liked. And this was before the internet, where you just could find anything you wanted all the time. I have to, you only spilled part of it, that's good. I won't really because I give them to you, but I'll give you one. It made me sound like I was real giving. The truth is I'm just going to say, can I have a beer and then hand it to his head? It does not make the thought any less. When I used to sneak down to shows at the Exit Inn, the truth be told, one of the nights that I stuck down there was to see a band from Athens, Georgia called Driving for Crime. I went with my best friend and we tried to pull our jean jacket collars up just high enough, to pull our hair down just far enough so that they wouldn't realize that we were 16 years old and we had to be 21 to get in. So we just stood there looking like 14-year-olds trying to act like 21. I remember getting to the door and paying my $10. The guy said, you can't come in. You're not 21. And I made up some excuse about where my ID was. He wasn't believing any of it because it was a lie. He was a half-decent security fellow. So I stood there on Elliston Place that night in Nashville, Tennessee, outside of the tinted window, and I watched the silhouettes of a band called Driving and Crying to play inside. But I've always wanted to thank Kevin and the guys because fortunately, at that point in their career, they were possibly the loudest fucking band I've ever heard. And so, whilst I could not see them particularly well, I heard every single note perfectly clear. There are hundreds of people and through the brick walls and the glass windows. It's amazing what a couple of Marshall full stacks turned up to 11 can do. So this is for them this evening. Way back on the radio dial, fire got lit inside a bright eyed child. Hidden note just wrapped around the soul. Steel guitar to Memphis, all the way to rock and roll.
Thank you.
back home for his birthday, and we missed it by one day. So happy belated birthday to St. Louis's own, the loud and the proud, my friend over here right on the lead guitar. Put your St. Louis hands together for this St. Louis gentleman, Mr. Tom Donovan.